Hey everybody, how's it? Aloha, this is Jeebs here, your decomposer here, decomposing on the Decomposer Lounge. And Infected Mushroom, okay? So I've heard of this band. It's a duo. I did a little bit of homework, and they, I guess, came around 1996 era. But their genre was very unique when I came across it. It said progressive metal, then electronica and dance. So I know I'm going to be in for something totally super cool beans. This is kind of coming on the heels of when last year I did something on an artist named Spongle. And then, of course, I just did, oh my gosh, I'm going to make this mistake. Twin Aphex. If I'm not looking at it, so if I made the mistake, I'm sorry. So I've been getting a lot of suggestions, you know, for more of the electronic, you know, hybrid kind of work. And thank you so much who are educating me about the kinds of beats that I don't know what they are. This is what I love about this channel. But that being said, today I am doing the song Heavyweight by Infected Mushroom. Thank you guys for your support. Links down below. Cup of coffee. Check out the headsets. Links down below. Link down below for the merch. And of course, the links down below for Patreon. So let's do this. Infected Mushroom, Heavyweight. All right. Well, there's no two ways about it. This is an extreme form of a hybrid. I only say EDM because I'm learning the lingo and the genre. So please be gentle with me. I'm just an old guy and I'm learning. But this this digital hybrid with the drums and the guitar, I really super dug. It, to me, I don't know when this was released. This album was released in 2007. To me, this is really super sick, kind of like video game, you know, first person kind of music. What do I know, right? It's just me. Excuse me. But I watch my kids play video games, so I listen to a little bit what's going on. And I just love the way that they start off with these really unique, it doesn't sound really super digital, it sounds more analog, you know, synth kind of arpeggiations, and then they bleed us into the drums and the metal guitars, and then they kind of then scoop another pile of more very progressive electronic sounds on top of it, but still keep the power and the grind moving forward. The one thing that I'm learning about these genres is that they are so rhythmic centric, but yet they really glam on a lot of ambient pads or ambient samples that either they develop and then they loop and they trick out. Like there was that melodic lady's voice that was coming in and out and stuff like that. And excuse me, for me, as progressive as this is and stuff, and you know, a lot more digital and or I'm sorry, analog or synthesized use of synthesizers in this kind of music, for me at my age, it doesn't set me off. It doesn't make me go, oh well, yeah. No, I really super dig this because I'm a very rhythmical arranger. So when I hear musicians or artists use techniques to really mess with your head in the hearing dynamics, and your head says sounds come here, they blow up here, or a rhythm pattern is set, and then like that, the same rhythm pattern's happening with a whole different set of sounds, that's really super trick shit, and I'm really digging that. This is a long song, so I'm gonna start up again, but I'm gonna see if I can't go for another, you know, good chunk of minutes before I come in with some more thoughts. So let me go back a little bit, and away. And this has taken me across so many dimensions of sonic experiences here. It's hard for me to really lock onto one thing and start to glam about it, because within eight bars, there's such a unique shift that they keep taking me through. Even at the beginning when I first came back in and they started to have that kind of syncopated vibe going on, it almost felt like a meter change happened, and all of a sudden it did drop right into what felt like a 3-4. 6-8-3-4, and they were really playing with my head with that rhythmical program. That's where it took me. All of a sudden, I went into what, you know, going into counting and stuff like that. And unfortunately, because I am a composer and I'm afflicted, which means I'm not a pure listener. And when I listen, you know, for those of you who are the first time who are hanging out here, I don't listen with those ears that you get to listen to music with as a pure listener. So I'm dissecting and popping and listening and, you know, kind of popping into like, what synth is that? And how could they have done this and all this sort of stuff? And just when I feel like I'm getting myself locked in, they completely shift a dimension. And in the sense that it's really dry, synthy kind of sounds that are crispy, and then all of a sudden they drop in this really big, fat, ambient kind of arrangement behind it, which completely changes, obviously, the experience. And that's what I love about this. And something else I need to ask you guys before I start this back up is I'm really not familiar with the public response to this music. What I mean by that is, what kind of clubs or events is it that this music is played? Is this like where the raves that I used to hear about that have been in the deserts in California, where they, you know, dance around with the glow sticks and stuff? And I know you're probably laughing your ass off at me going, oh, cute old guy, here's a noogie. Go stay in the middle of the island, in an island in the middle of the ocean. Stay put. But I love learning. That's what this is all about. So if you wouldn't mind helping me out understand where music like this is played, you know, predominantly in for the masses, what kind of events are they? That'd be pretty badass. Okay, let me start up here and I'll finish this up and yeah. Super trick ending by using the effects. It sounds like they use this kind of super long decay on a reverb or something. This was great. I'm slightly overloaded, but and it's hard for me to quote unquote give a reaction because there are so many great little pieces in there that I might have to go back and actually type in thoughts as I re-listen to this, because every time I heard something new, I just, oh man, I got to mention something about that. But then I would have stopped minute and a half, and that's not allowing me to get into the track. I loved how they just so infused, you know, organic drums, you know, over all the synthesized works and the programmings and stuff. That melody or the lead work that was just happening in this last listen that I, you know, for me, it definitely sounds like it's a keyboard using the mod wheel and the pitch bend. But at the same token, I know that there are different guitar controllers that you could do that on as well. And but this is 1996, so I don't know what was available back then. But I'm going to lean on the fact that that was keyboard work with, you know, a mod wheel and the pitch bend, and that was fantastic. Right on top, also must if that is the case. Apparently also has some pretty intense experience guitar solo wise because it was really performed in that nature. And once again, excuse me, hearing the live drums while all these unique synth sounds were coming and popping in and kept, it was just kind of these little starbursts of, like, I don't know if you're just on a really super good mushroom trip. Is that why they call it infected mushroom? I don't know. But it was like these starbursts of brilliance and these little bits and pieces and stuff. And I really do appreciate this kind of music. And I can, because also as a composer, you know, when you're writing for visuals, it's not about how big of a piece you can put against a visual. Sometimes it's this one little thing that you do that can completely change a mood or something, and that's what I felt what was happening here. That's why I had this full theater of the mind going as well. Even though my brain is trying to dissect, you know, all of the different layers and stuff, I still was kind of gliding and tripping. I found myself kind of gliding a few times going, oh shit, I better get back to this. But this was great. Infected Mushroom for the win. Thank you guys for suggesting it, as well as thank you for being patient and explaining to me as I'm kind of slowly drifting, you know, through the analog and the digital music world and stuff like that. This is still all going to be about metal and rock and roll as much as I do, but I'm also starting, as you can see, to spread my wings and go in different directions. So thank you very much for your suggestions. If you're still here, type in "I'm still here." Of course, first time here, if you like the video, that's badass. If you'd like to subscribe, even better. And if you want to buy me a cup of coffee, chew! All right. All right, everybody, take care. Aloha. Yahoo! All right.